great artists in India, but their art is only understood by the intellectuals.
Modern art is fine. It's all right. But it's cosmopolitan and international. The poor peasant cannot understand it, and I wish to speak to the people. Therefore, I think that I am the painter of the people.
For 50 years, Sobha Singh has been painting popular themes in popular forms. The mythological mood provided the key both to his own inspiration and to the people's response. Born in 1901, he joined the army as a draftsman in 1919 and went to Iraq.
But in 1923, I came back to India and decided to live as an artist. I painted posters, book covers, portraits, anything I could do to support myself.
Abstraction never held any place in a mind that sought clarity and immediate impact. His paintings remained realistic, obvious, therefore dear to the heart of the common man. Sobha Singh was born a romanticist. He idealized reality. He made even wrinkles look beautiful. His early training gave his lines fluency, and his later maturity gave his images substance, especially to the image of the female form. First etched with delicacy, then with passion. His women became warm, alive, faces and figures to stir the imagination and the senses. But Sobha Singh is like all romanticists, haunted by a sense of the tragic. His heroines are lovely but poignant creatures, drawn from the imperial pages of Mughal history or from the famous love legends that haunt the vivid heart of the Punjab. Soni Mahiwal, the painting that became a nostalgic visual refrain for every Punjabi eye. And then the drumbeat of a new vision, the military hero, from woman to man, the love of woman which can, he says, flow into the love of God. God in the shape of the strong, the manly, the warrior hearts of the Sikhs. Sobha Singh's sensuous creations of the past now turned spiritual. Again the passion came alive, but in a different form, Again the lines were sharply drawn, but the contours were different. The tragic comment on love between man and woman turned to the philosophic dialogue between a Sheikh Farid and his God. The religious hero became his final visual passion. From his fingers streamed endless images of Guru Nanak, the epitome of the final search, the final word, the final inspiration.
अपने सेवक की आपे राखे आपे नाम जपावे जय जय काज सिरत सेवक की पाए पाए उठावे पाए पाए.
The people responded with fervor. These were images they wanted to possess, revere, and worship. Sobha Singh became a living legend, a painter who gave physical shape to the idea of romance and religion in terms the people understood. He had no pretensions. He specified reality instead of defining. His paintings are found everywhere, from prints in the bazaars to portraits in Gurdwara. They are found in the Sikh Museum and the Golden Temple. In the State Museum at Chandigarh. In the homes of men of taste and learning. In a middle-class house where no other paintings hang but Sobha Singh, as aesthetic object and religious symbols.